Hello YouTube, welcome to today's video. Today I'm going to talk to you about primitives in Rescript. Let's use our basic template that we have created in the very first video. Oh yeah, if you're using VS Code, I highly recommend you to install the Visual Studio Code Rescript extension. It contains all the tooling that you need to use Rescript right away. I'm gonna talk about how to properly learn Rescript. First, you need to already know JavaScript. It makes sense because Rescript compiles to JavaScript. You can say it's a leaky abstraction. Why do we need to know about JavaScript? Sure. But so does all compile to JavaScript languages like TypeScript and CoffeeScript. You, of course, need to know JavaScript. Second, to gain intuition about Rescript, it's better to actually keep the generated JavaScript files side by side. So what we are going to do is type some code and then run the JavaScript compiler, and then we will inspect the generated JavaScript code. So in here, I have my terminal open with my text editor on the left and the terminal on the right. On the text editor, I have the left side opening a Rescript file and the right side opening the compiled JavaScript file. First, let's talk about string. And you can see here it compiles to regular JavaScript. You can also concatenate the strings. We can also use string interpolation just like JavaScript. Interestingly, Rescript actually compiles the string interpolation into regular concatenation. Second, we're going to talk about char. Although JavaScript doesn't have the concept of char, but Rescript actually does. Let's take a look what does this code compiles to. So interestingly, Rescript actually compiles it to an ASCII code. Next, we have a Boolean data type. And it compiles to regular Boolean. As you expect, the Boolean here also have regular Boolean operations that you know. So interestingly, Rescript compiler actually evaluates the expression and it gives you the final value of the expression. So I think this is one of the optimization that Rescript has. If it can find an expression that can be evaluated right away, it will actually do it. This can actually make your compiled JavaScript code faster than if you're writing it yourself. Next, we have integer. Unlike JavaScript, Rescript has a distinct type between integer and float. So as you can see here, the Rescript compiler actually evaluates the expression again. You can also do the plus, minus, and division. Let's check out what happens if we do a division with a zero denominator. So what is this thing? Let's try to run it. It seems like an exception. Division by zero error. We're going to learn about exception later, so stay tuned. For a float data type, we can have the same operators like integer, but we need to add dot into it. For example, so if we run this, it says this has type float, but somewhere wanted int. This is because the operator multiplication here is for int with int. But if we want to do operations on float, we need to add dot. With adding dot, it works as usual. What happens if you change one of the data type to be int? So for example, this one. Then it complains again. This has type int and somewhere wanted float. So Rescript type system is working for us. So I think now is a good segue to talk about primitive types that Rescript has. We can actually annotate our let bindings with the types. We can also create a type alias. You can actually make the variable name here custName, the same name as the customer name. And it will work. So please don't be confused on the syntax. Customer name, colon, and customer name. The left side of the colon is just the variable name. And the right side of the colon is just the type name. So, that's all for today. In the next video, we will take a look at composite data types. Let me know what are your thoughts. If you like this type of content, press the like button, and don't forget to subscribe. I'll see you next time.